Eddie, so good to talk to you. And I ask everybody this thing, how old were you and where were you that music started, you know, being a thing for you?
I think love of music. I had a couple uncles. I was the oldest of the kids, but I had a couple uncles who, you know, I'd steal their Beatles records when I'd go visit grandma's. They were living with grandma, and I remember stealing Yellow Submarine, you know, just for the week. They'd track it down eventually, and Woodstock had a lot of stuff. So that was, I was 5 or 6, but somehow, you know, we'd go listen to the records at their, at where they were staying, and then I'd want to take them home, and I did. And they were okay with that. Mm-hmm. But I think they influenced me, and then I spent some time at a group home in Chicago. My parents were these foster parents, and then there was older kids around. It was in Chicago, so there was older kids and African-American kids and Irish kids. And in the basement, we had a turntable, and they had, like, Sly Family Stone and all the Motown stuff. And even, like, the Jackson 5, because then there was a kid who was, like, 8, and I was 6, and he could sing. And I think I just started singing to those records.
So you started singing first?
Yeah. Uh-huh. Yeah, I picked up a guitar when I was about 12.
And then when you picked up the guitar, did you take lessons, or did it just come out?
For about... I think I had like 6 lessons, and then he went on vacation, and then I just started learning kind of on my own, and I never went back. I actually just recently talked to that guitar teacher about 2 weeks ago for the first time in 30 years.
Wow.
And so I'm going to start taking lessons again.
Yeah.
I just wanted to be from the one guy.
That's pretty good. And so 13 or 14, you're playing guitar and singing. And so where did the road, you know, lead you here?
Well, I kind of toughed it out for a bit, and at one point I gave myself a certain amount of years. You know, I figured till I was 30 to kind of do something as a musician, and you know, I had little bands, and I was really into home recording, where you have, because that was right at the advent of the 4-track recorder, where you could do home recording in a very consumer-friendly way, and just on cassette, 4-track cassette, mm-hmm. and so I'd overdub and write songs. I kind of would study the Pete Townsend demos and certain people that played all the instruments themselves, and so I'd kind of work on writing like that, and played in bands here and there, and got better at it, and then ended up in Seattle and.
Now, how'd you go out to Seattle?
A good friend of mine, got an offer to play drums in a band up there. And they said, by the way, do you know any singers? And he threw me a tape. And I was working midnight shifts at a gas station and recorded on a 4-track that morning, like 3 songs, and sent them off and never thought anything about it. And then a couple weeks later, they flew me up to Seattle and we started playing together. And
that's history.
Yeah, it was a good, you know, it's funny because we've been listening to that stuff recently because we put out some of that early demo stuff and I hadn't heard it since, 18 years ago or something. And it was interesting to hear, almost terrifying, because I don't really remember spending more than 3 or 4 hours on these 3 songs and recording them and background vocals or whatever. But it was probably in the end, you know, I look to where I have a family now and I get to travel and my life's been really quite full. I think of it as like the best life I've ever lived so far. And I think, wow, that was an important 3 or 4 hours. Yeah. I didn't realize it at the time, yeah. Which is probably good. But
tomorrow night, Eddie, you're going to be on the stage at Radio City Music Hall. And it's so great of you to come out and support this initiative to teach 1 million kids transcendental meditation. Tell me about how you came to be doing this and what your thoughts are on that.
Well, the one thing I'll say is that because of my appreciation, my deep appreciation for your work, and when I got the call from you, and I felt like, wow, I've been waiting a long time for this call. Not that I'd expected it, but it was really exciting, and not knowing necessarily what it was about. And if you would have called and asked me, you know, if you said there was some yard work you needed done around the house, I would have been there.
Bless your heart, Eddie.
And then it turns out that what you have in mind has much more of a societal and global connotation. So it's a it's a massive exercise in doing something really positive that, again, is this non-denominational and you know, you said something years ago that always stuck with me, and it was something, and it was very simple, but you said, you know, ideas, they're the best thing going.
Mm-hmm.
And it really, really stuck with me, and then here it is. It's really, this one in particular is one of the better ideas.
Beautiful, Eddie. That's really good. Really good.
Yeah.
And thanks a million for doing this interview, and more importantly, for being on the stage tomorrow night.
Well, and thank you for bringing this to the people and doing it with such a, you know, a strong, galvanized approach and with such focus, and we're so proud to be part of it, yeah.